Hi everybody, it's time for the Makeup Basket Debrief and the new items for the week. So, last week I was away at home in upstate New York visiting my sister. She had an art show. She's graduating with, I want to say it's a fine arts or a graphic arts bachelor's degree. So one of the requirements that they have, the school requires the students to have kind of a show, and she does it with everyone else in the program, and they put it in their gallery, aka a barn, but okay, it's a school, and they show their art, and everybody can come and look at it for about 2 weeks. So because I just started this job, I thought, let me go to the art show, because my parents, who are in Florida, aren't going to be able to attend the art show. They'll be attending the commencement at the end of the month. So I thought, I'll go to the art show and represent. So I did. My sister's pretty talented. So we're very, very different in terms of personality. And that's okay. So her work is very great. It's very, very good. It's incredibly complex. I'm glad she had put a little statement by her pictures, because I never would have understood half of what she had up there. And that's just me. Like, I need it kind of spelled out sometimes. But it was a good experience. The traveling was a little bit too much for me this time around. I think I'm getting to the point where the driving is starting to take a toll. And since I started my new job, I'm just exhausted, still trying to get my feet under me and really stand up and start making a difference and contributing to my new workplace. So, but I do really like it. It is a learning curve. It is challenging at times, but I'm hoping that I can really kind of gain some footing here and make a mark and really stick around. So that's that. Ramble, ramble, ramble. So let's get to the items. These were the items I actually took with me. And here they are. I didn't take that. I used that. I didn't take it. The Essence Get Big Lashes Volume Boost Waterproof Mascara. I think I mentioned before that this is really starting to grow on me. It wasn't my favorite before, but it's okay. It's okay. And the fact that it's waterproof really makes a huge difference for me. So, and I took my Jordana Fabuliner in black. This was a gift from Stacey Sunnyside Makeup. These are wonderful. And I'm so mad at myself because when I was back in the U.S., I did not look for these. And I should have looked for them a little harder. Maybe driven to like two more drugstores, and I probably would have found them and I would have bought more because these are great. The Chanel Barrel Long Lasting Liner. This is another favorite of mine. I alternate between this and the Rimmel Scandalized Nude Pencil, but I actually kind of prefer this. The Rimmel pencil is nice because it's a little bit softer than this, but it tends to really kind of cake up on me, and I feel like this lavender looks a little bit more natural. The Rimmel Wake Me Up Anti-Fatigue Effect Concealer, one of my favorites. Probably, I don't know if I could say it's my absolute favorite drugstore concealer, because I don't feel like I've tried enough, but it's definitely a big favorite. Definitely a top five concealer drugstore for me. The NARS Pro Prime Smudge Proof Eyeshadow Base. This was okay. I'm really a diehard Urban Decay Primer Potion fan. I've been using the Eden. I'm probably going to go back to the original in the purple tube, because I'm using the one in like the beige-ish kind of tube. And it's good. This was okay, but I wouldn't buy a full size of this. I just didn't like the consistency. Did the job, but I didn't like the consistency. My big lifesaver for this week was my NARS The Happening Eye and Cheek Palette. I love palettes that put things together for me. There's no guesswork. There's no, you know, does this go with this? Does this complement this? And when I was traveling, this was definitely my lifesaver, because I took one product and didn't have to take a bunch of eyeshadows, separate blush and bronzer. It just makes things a lot heavier and clunkier. This had everything in it. And I truly love the colors. The colors are so versatile. You can use them in so many different ways. And yeah, this was a good purchase. I'm really happy with this. Because I almost walked right on by that. There's a story behind that, but not right now. We're not doing that now. My Dr. Jart Black Label Detox BB Beauty Balm. I've worn the label off this one. Again, originally Stacy Sunnyside Makeup turned me on to this, and I really, really, really love it. I've actually taken to just wearing this this week and no foundation on top. In part because my office is beastly hot and I have no idea why, but this just covers so well that I don't need the extra foundation, especially if it's going to slide off my face because my office is hot. Something I didn't mention or didn't show in the video last time when I announced I was using these products, but I did use it, is my Shu Uemura UV Underbase Mousse. I love this stuff, and I know they make it in limited editions where they have pretty little packaging and all sorts of designs on it. That's fine, but I happened to buy it when they didn't have that. They didn't have a limited edition. I don't need the limited edition package. I just need the product. So I really do like this quite a bit. Definitely does the job. I think this is going to really help me through summer because it's nice and light. It's a mousse, and it kind of turns into a liquid, obviously, as you put it, apply it to your face. And there is some coverage. It is tinted. It's beige. So it does provide something. So if you need the SPF and you don't want to wear foundation and your skin is in good condition, why not? Why not just wear this? Now, I also used my sample that came in my Holt Renfrew beauty bag of the Laura Mercier Universal Setting Powder. I like this. This reminds me of that NARS makes one of these. Makeup Forever makes one of these universal powders that are white in color and have a lot of light reflecting and refracting particles. But what I really liked about this is the little fan brush that came with it. And I didn't bring that down because it's actually drying. I washed all my brushes today. So, but would I purchase this again? Probably not. But it's like the perfect size for travel. And the fan brush, that is, I love it. I just love that. Now, the other thing that I used that I didn't bring out was my Dior lip polish, and I'm just trying to use that up. And again, that's a great product. It fills in the lines and kind of gives you just a teensy bit of color. So it's a My Lips But Better, but what I really like it for is filling in the lines and making my lips look pretty universally awesome. So, all right, that's enough of that. Now, I did haul quite a bit from the States. Surprisingly, or not, I'm not using any of that in my makeup basket for this week. I'm really, really, really focusing on using things up, and I do have a lot of like summer palettes, spring palettes, but I don't know how the weather is where you are, but up here in Canada, specifically Toronto, Ontario, we're back down to winter weather, and I'm talking like if you're a Fahrenheit gal, we're back in the 30s. Celsius, we're down to 1, 2, 3, 4 degrees, and that is freezing. So winter jacket's still hanging in the closet. Went out with a winter jacket today, and I was like, oh, when will this be over? So because of that, I'm not going crazy with my summer spring palettes because it just doesn't feel like that yet. Okay, anyway, enough of that. I'm using my Wet n Wild Comfort Zone palette. This is probably one of my favorite drugstore palettes ever. And of course, you YouTubers really encouraged me to get it, and I'm so glad I did. So many looks, so many things to do with this palette. It's fantastic. For my BB cream, I'm using one of my favorite super BB triple function whitening UV protecting. This is in the pink from Skin 79. I believe it was Lori from LL2483. I don't know how to say her channel name, but she actually mentioned this and I went and got it and I love it. And also Joseph Birdsong from the Stylish Vids, he uses that as well. Then something I did buy in the States and I am going to use is my Dr. Jart CC Essence Balm Treatment Serum and Color Correction with SPF 24. So here's the container. This is what it looks like when you don't start using it. Obviously, when you start using it, it kind of gets muddied, the colors in between. This looks like the Olay stuff. The Olay compact. Olay makes one that's similar. I like to use this on top of the BB. It warms up color-wise. It kind of warms up my face just a tad. As you know, Dr. Jart, this Skin 79 have a gray cast when you take it out of the, when you pump it out of the container. When you apply it to the skin, it does color adjust, which is wonderful. So these two I'm hoping will be a winning combination this week. Then for foundation, but I'm probably not going to use foundation, just trying to use up my Bourjois Healthy Mix Serum, the gel 16 hours radiance boosting. I don't think it's 16 hours. It is a nice foundation. Remember, I can't remember anybody's name. Nicola Maria, she mentioned that this foundation and Chanel foundation have a similar scent, and that's because they are owned and or distributed by the same company. For gloss, I'm using my Bobbi Brown Neons Ultraviolet 4. This is kind of like a jelly-ish gloss, which I really do like that. I should have bought the pink one. I don't know why I didn't. Then the Glamorous Eyebrow Pencil in number 1. So it's just got the brush on the one end, and here's this. Then for my makeup base, I'm just trying to use up my Dior Capsule Total Multi-Perfection UVB Base. This is high protection. Almost done with this. I'm about halfway through. For setting powder, if I need it, my Cover FX in Light. Again, trying to use this up. I'm thinking one or two more weeks and I'll be done with this. The Dior Liquid Liner in Black. For bronzer, one of my favorites, Victoria's Secret Makeup Sun Goddess, what do they call this? Baked Mineral Bronzing Powder. I don't even think they make this anymore, and that is a shame. For concealer, Giorgio Armani Maestro Eraser. For waterproof mascara, just in case, Essence 24 Hour stays no matter what. And for days it's not going to be raining or snowing potentially, Bourjois Volume Glamour Max Definition. Just trying to use this up. This is one of my meh mascaras. I'm not really into it. Blush, I'm using my Milani Baked Blush in Rose D'Oro, one of my favorites. Nice warm tones in that. And then for lipstick, trying to use this up, 687, can't say it, it's a Dior Addict, ESPIEGLE. It's a beautiful color. There we are. So, that's it. This video went on a little bit too long, and I'm not a fan of doing that. But I hope you all had a great week, and thanks so much for watching. Bye.